This afternoon, our prayer session, we'd like to continue the topic, Does your temple lies in ruin for mutual encouragement?
今天下午的晚祷会, 我要继续上一次的主题, 你的殿是否荒凉?
Let's turn to the book of Haggai.
我们一起翻到哈该书,
chapter 1, verse 4.
第一章第四节,
Haggai chapter 1, verse 4.
哈该书第一章第四节,
Let's read together.
我们一起读,
1, 2, 3.
Is it time for you yourself to dwell in your panel houses
and the temple to lie in ruins? This is the message of God to the people.
这是神对百姓的讯息.
Does your temple lie in ruin?
这殿是否仍然荒凉呢?
This temple belongs to God.
这殿属于神.
This temple is the place to worship God.
这殿是敬拜神的地方.
It's the place to glorify God.
并且也是荣耀神的地方.
It's the place where God dwells.
这也是神所居住的地方.
It's the place where we talk to God, where we meet with God.
这也是我们与神相会, 与神谈话的地方.
During that time, the physical temple was lying in ruin.
在那个时候, 神的殿仍然处于荒凉的阶段.
Because people have lost their love to God.
因为人们失去他们对神的爱.
They don't really care about the house of God.
他们并不在乎神的殿,
so that they don't want to continue rebuilding the temple.
所以他们没有力量再继续建造神的殿.
Today, not only we have to rebuild the wall,
今天我们不只要重建城墙,
we also have to rebuild the temple.
我们必须也要重建圣殿.
Because the wall is to protect the temple.
因为这个城墙就是保护圣殿的.
To repair the wall is a passive attitude.
在重建城墙这方面是一个消极的做法。
Anywhere have bridges, a gap, you close it.
哪里有破口我们就补哪里。
But building the temple is something we have to take it proactively.
可是重建圣殿我们必须要有正面的思想。
A few days ago, we talked about the first point, we have to work in the temple in our heart.
几天前我们有谈到我们必须要在心里重建神的殿。
Because the temple of God is our heart.
因为神的殿就是我们的心.
If you do not work on it, it will continue to lie in ruin.
如果我们不这样做, 我们的心, 我们的圣殿就会仍然荒凉.
Now, today we also talk about the second point.
今天我们要来谈第二点.
Is your personal altar lies in ruin?
你的个人祭坛是否处于荒凉呢?
When we talk about the holy city, holy temple, we talk about a very grand scale.
当我们提到圣城还有圣殿, 我们就会想到很大的工程。
It's a grand and big temple.
是非常 豪美的华美的圣殿。
However, if you look at what the temple it consists of,
可是如果我们想一想这个圣殿到底代表什么?
It consists of every brick, every small part.
其实是由每一个一砖一瓦所建造而成的。
And what is the basic building block?
那最重要的这个根基是什么?
Is the personal faith.
就是个人的信仰.
Today, the church of God is the holy temple of God.
今天神的教会就是神的圣殿.
But in our church, if we do not have strong family,
可是如果在教会里面我们没有 信仰很坚强的家庭,
then we do not have a strong church.
那我们就没有一个坚强的教会.
Thank God Preacher Chen talks about how to build a Christian center, Christ-centered family.
感谢神刚刚陈传道为我们勉励如何建造基督化的家庭。
And family, Christian family also start with individual.
基督化的家庭也是由个人建造而成。
So we will want to talk about how about your personal altar.
所以现在我们要来谈一谈如何建造个人的祭坛。
Now we will look at why the personal altar was broken.
我们现在来看一看为什么个人祭坛是仍然荒凉的。
Because sin was there, so that the personal altar was broken.
因为罪性仍在, 所以个人祭坛是荒凉的。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 4.
我们来翻到创世纪第四章。
Genesis chapter 4.
创世纪第四章。
Genesis chapter 4, verse 6 to 7.
第四章第六到第七节。
Genesis chapter 4, verse 6 to 7.
创世纪第四章第六到第七节。
Let's read together.
我们一起读。
So the law said to Cain, why are you angry? And why has your countenance fallen? 7. If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sins lie at the door, and it desires for you. and you should rule over it. Here tell us, after Adam committed sin, the personal altar of worshiping God has been broken.
这里讲到，当亚当犯罪之后，个人的祭坛就已经破裂了。
So the connection to God is not there anymore.
所以与神的连结已经断绝。
Because they were cast out of Eden.
因为他们已经被赶出伊甸园。
They are not talking to God anymore, and God is not talking to them.
他们不与神谈话，神也不再对他们说话。
Can you imagine if you're having a very nice phone?
你可以想一想，如果你有一台非常好的手机。
Nowadays, some good phone costs more than $1,000.
现在一台好的手机可能超过$1,000.
And you're willing to spend this money.
而有人也是很愿意花这一分钱。
Why?
为什么？
Because you think your phone is very beautiful.
因为你想说这台手机非常好，非常漂亮。
It can take a lot of pictures.
而且也可以拍很多照片。
Have good memory, a lot of storage.
里面也有很大的储存量。
A very fast chip inside.
里面也有很快的晶片。
Yes, you're willing to spend $1,000 or more for that phone.
所以你愿意花超过$1,000来拥有这部手机。
But think about this, if your phone is not able to go online.
可是想一想，如果这部手机没有办法连上网。
Cannot connect to Wi-Fi, cannot connect to your phone network.
它没有办法接通通讯公司，也没有办法连上网路。
Then what is that phone for?
那部手机还有什么用呢？
That phone is a piece of electronic junk.
它就只是一个科技垃圾而已。
It's no use at all because it cannot be connected.
因为它完全连不上线，所以它只是个垃圾。
Can you think about we as a Christian?
我们来想一想，我们自己是个基督徒。
Yes, God has prepared this good hardware for us.
是的，神为我们预备这很好的
硬体。
硬体。
We have good health, we have good brain, we have good physical stature.
我们有很好的头脑，很好的身体。
And God gives us everything that we need.
神也给了我们一切我们所需的
so that we can worship him, we can glorify him, we can manifest his glory.
让我们可以在生活当中来荣耀他。
But if we cannot connect to God,
可是如果我们不与神连线的话，
just like that phone is a junk, it's useless.
就像刚刚讲到的那部手机，它只是一个垃圾。
If a Christian cannot connect to God,
如果一个基督徒无法与神连线的话，
also in God's eyes, we are also useless.
在神的眼中，我们一样是无用的。
But unfortunately, nowadays, a lot of us are very willing to become a very beautiful spiritual junk.
很不幸的，今天很多人却愿意成为这样美丽的垃圾。
Yes, I have good career.
是的，我有很好的事业。
I've earned some money.
我也赚到了钱。
And I have lived a good life.
我的生活也过得挺不错。
I am educated.
我也受很高的教育。
Just like what the world set the standard, we are following it.
就像这个世界给我们的标准，我们就跟着这个标准走。
But we are not connected to God.
可是我们并没有与神连接。
Because the only way to connect to God is to build an altar and to worship God.
因为能够与神连接的方式就是建造个人祭坛，并且来敬拜神。
But after Adam sinned, he didn't build any altar.
可是在亚当犯罪之后，他没有办法再建造这样的祭坛。
Because his relationship with God is broken.
因为他与神的关系已经断绝。
Now, that not only affects him, but also affects his children.
这不只是影响到他本人，还影响到他的子孙。
Cain already have sinned, and then God is angry with Cain.
该隐已经犯罪，并且神也发怒了。
There's sin in the heart of Cain, is hatred, is jealousy.
因为该隐的心充满了仇恨。
In verse 8,
在第八节
Verse 8,
第八节
Let's read together loud, 1, 2, 3.
一起大声读。
该隐与他兄弟亚伯说话，二人正在田间，该隐起来打他兄弟亚伯，把他杀了。 We can see a family or the parents or the family member not connect to God, what will the problem bring?
我们可以看见，在一个家庭里面，如果人没有与神连线的话，这家庭会到底发生什么事？
It's conflicts.
就是有很多的冲突。
Right, this, you know, Cain wanted to kill Abel, and he did it.
该隐很想要杀了他的弟弟，结果最后真的把他杀了。
I think when Adam and Eve knew about it, they will feel very, very painful.
我相信当亚当夏娃听到这个消息的时候，他们绝对很心痛。
Maybe if you are youth, you are not a parent yet, you will not understand this.
可能你只是个青年，你还没有当人的父母，你还没有办法了解。
But when you become parent,
可是当有一天你成了人家的父母，
one of the things that can really hurt your heart is you see your children fighting and arguing.
有一件事可以让你很心痛的，就是你看见你的孩子整日都在吵架。
You feel very annoyed first.
你也会觉得很烦。
And then secondly, if they keep on annoying each other, hating each other, then your heart feels broken.
如果他们继续这样吵架下去，并且痛恨彼此，那我们当父母的心就会破裂。
Because both are the children, both are your children.
因为他们都是你的孩子。
And then if they kill each other, then your heart is even broken further.
如果他们杀了彼此，你的心就会更是碎了。
The Bible did not record how Adam and Eve feel, but we are very sure that their heart is broken.
圣经里面虽然没有记载亚当夏娃当时的心情，可是我们可以相信他们绝对是心痛的。
They have really regretted, oh, maybe we really shouldn't have sinned against God, and now all this problem is bring to our family.
可能他们在心里就痛痛的、后悔，想说我们当初不应该背叛神，这样我们的家庭才不会走到今天的下场。
You know, family order was broken, family relationship, personal relationship was broken, then family also broken.
家庭祭坛破裂就代表家庭成员之间的关系也是破裂的。
But there's a way to rebuild it.
可是有一个方法可以重建它。
And this, in this, when we look at this chapter, we can see how to rebuild it.
我们细细的来读这一章，我们就可以看见如何重建。
But of course, it takes a while for someone to realize what the problem.
当然，这个也要从有人、感觉到这个问题的存在而开始。
Now, well, when Cain committed sin, he killed his brother, then he was cast out of God, just like Adam, he was cast out of Garden of Eden.
当该隐犯罪之后，他被神赶出他的面，就像他的父亲亚当一样。
Let's read verse 16.
我们来读16节。
Verse 16.
16节。
Let's read.
于是该
隐离开耶和华的面，去住在伊甸。Then Cain went out from the presence of the Lord and dwelt in the land of Nod on the east of Eden. 17.
17. 该隐与妻子同房，他妻子就怀孕，生了以诺。该隐建造了一座城，就按着他儿子的名，将那城叫做以诺。
Now here tell us the Cain when he left the face of the law.He continued to develop and become successful.
我们看见当该隐被赶出神的面之外，他开始过着一个成功的生活。
In a worldly standard, Cain was very successful.
以世界的角度来看，该隐是一个非常成功的人。
Why?
为什么？
Because he was very smart.
因为他很聪明。
I don't need God, you know. I can still live a good life.
我不需要神，我还是可以过一个很好的日子。
And then I can...build a city.
我甚至的建造了一座城。
You know, this is a very advanced thinking.
这是一个非常超越当时时代的思想。
Because before that, there was no city.
因为在那个年代之前是没有城的。
Now, today we all live in city.
今天我们都是住在城市里。
Can you imagine most of us, right? When we were born, we were born in city.
其实我们大部分的人都是生在城市里面。
And then we study in city, we work in city.
我们也在城市里读书，也在城市里工作。
City is the concept to gather the people together and then make business, many interaction of human activities.
城市的作用就是把人聚集在一起，并且可以、做交易。
And then cultural increase, and then technology can increase faster.
那因为人们的聚在一起，那科技也可以逐渐的进步。
So what is the first city?
所以什么、哪一座城市世界的第一座呢
？It's the city called Enoch. It's the son of Cain.
就是以诺城，这个以诺就是该隐的儿子。
So Cain was very smart.
所以该隐是一个非常聪明的人。
He can improve his life very well.
他可以、给自己的生活带来进步。
But his life doesn't have God.
可是他的生命当中没有神。
His life doesn't worship God.
他也没有敬拜神。
His life is very self-centered.
他的生命是以自我为中心的。
He want to make this city known so that people remember he has a son called Enoch.
他想要使这个城能够大大发光，让世界上的人都知道他有一个儿子叫以诺。
So this is self-centered.
这就是自我中心。
Today, we are living in the culture of self-centeredness.
今天我们也是活在一个世界是以自我为中心的。
Right? What is the most popular phone?
什么电话是最出名的呢
？Of course, children can say it's iPhone.
当然，孩子们都知道叫 iPhone.
iPad.
iPad.
Why?
为什么
？Even the name is very attractive because everyone is focused on himself or herself.
就连这个名字都是那么吸引人，因为每一个人都想要以自我为中心。
It didn't say you pad, right? You phone. Well, it's mine. It's iPhone.
他不是说你的电话或是你的平板，而是说是我的电话。
Everyone living in this world is to try to fulfill their own enjoyment, their own glory, their own achievement.
现代的人都是集中在自我的享乐、自我的中心思想上面。
Actually, it's nothing new.
这个其实不是什么新的概念。
It started with Cain.
从该隐的时候就这样了。
I did it. I want to glorify myself.
我做这件事就是要让我的名大大发扬
光大。I want people remember me and my children.
我要人们记得我的名字还有我孩子。
No, there's no altar there. There's no connection with God there.
他们的生命当中并没有足坛这件事，也没有与神连结。
They also don't want to repent and connect to God.
他们也不想回头悔改与神连接。
Now continue. If you look at the society, it looks very advanced.
我们继续读下去就可以看见当时的社会是非常发达的。
It looks at least on the surface.
在表面上看起来至少是很发达的。
Verse 18.
第十八节。
Verse 18.
十八。
1, 2, 3. To Enoch was born Ered, and Ered begot Mehujael, and Mehujael begot
Methuselah,
and Methuselah begot Lamech. And then next 20.
拉麦娶了两个妻，一个
名
叫亚大，一个名叫喜拉。
One was Ada, and the name of the second was Selah. Now, here the descendant of Cain continue to develop themselves.
现在该隐的子孙继续发展下去。
Now, let's just look at what Lamech did.
我们看看拉麦做了什么。
Lamech redefined marriage.
拉麦为婚姻定一个新的定义。
Because when God created human being, it's one husband, one wife.
因为当神设计婚姻的时候是一夫一妻。
But when human beings think that they are very smart, they are self-centered, they want to redefine everything God defined.
当人们觉得自己够聪明，可以去颠覆一些思想的时候，他们想要重新定义婚姻。
Because Lamech said to himself, one wife is not enough. I am a man. Why cannot I enjoy more?
所以拉麦就告诉自己说，为什么人不能娶多一点妻子呢？
I have money. I have food to feed more than one wife.
我有钱，我也有食物，我为什么不可以多娶一个呢？
I have desire, I want more.
我也有欲望，我想要更多的妻子。
So he redefined marriage.
所以他就为婚姻重新定义。
Now, when people disconnect with God, people do not worship God, they want to redefine things.
所以当人们不愿意敬拜神，不愿意与神连结的时候，他们想要为事物重新定义。
That is exactly what happened in this society right now.
这就是现今社会发展的事情。
The Bible tells us one husband, one wife.
圣经告诉我们是一夫一妻。
At that time, one husband, Lamech redefined it, one husband, two wives.
那时候拉麦已经说了一夫二妻。
And then nowadays, people redefine marriage.
现在的人也是为婚姻重新定义。
LGBTQ, everything goes. As long as love, love is love. They say love is love. Why only one man to one wife? One man to one woman?
现在的这些同性团体，他们说为什么是一夫一妻呢？也可以就是爱情就是爱情。
Well, people can go their own way.
人们可以照自己所想的去爱。
But the society will have more problem.
可是社会会有更多的问题。
If you read on this whole passage, the descendants of Cain are very smart.
我们如果继续读下去，就会发现该隐的子孙都非常的聪
明。They are so smart. They can make instruments. They can know how to pastor animals.
他们可以发明乐器，也可以知道如何牧养牲畜。
And then they are so smart. They can use the skill to extract copper and also iron to make weapon.
他们也知道如何弹琴，也知道如何打造各样铜铁利器。
Now, look at this. There's only a few generations.
我们看看这个只是几代人而已。
It is not according to nowadays anthropology, 人类学 so it takes millions of years for human to evolve from apes to become modern human being.
这不是像我们今天在学校学的人类学说到人们是经过几百年几千年才有办法进化到现在这样。
It's not according to what nowadays scientists said. It takes hundreds and thousands of years to move from likeStone Age, and then Metal Age, and then to modern human being.
也不是像现在在教科书上学到的，人们需要经过
几
万年，从
石器时代，
从石器时代到铁器时代，到后来的时代。
The Bible said it only take them a few generations. They are so smart, they know how to use it.
圣经告诉我们，其实人类很聪明，只有经过几代人，他们就发明出这么多不一样的东西。
They know how to take care of animals.
他们知道如何牧养牲畜。
And then they know how to make musical instruments.
也知道如何 发明这个乐器。
And then they know how to use metal, make metal.
也知道如何打造各样的铜铁。
They protect themselves.
来保护他们自己。
And then to fight battle.
并且打仗。
But everything comes with a negative side if you do not have God.
可是这一些都是从如果你没有神这一边进化而来。
Technology can advance.
科技是可以进步的。
For the good of human being.
对人类是有益处的。
But if we do not connect to God,
可是如果我们与神没有连线，
technology also can do harm to human being.
科技也可以伤害人类。
For example, the moment you know how to make iron, not only you make the plow, but also you make a knife, you can kill people.
譬如说，当你会打造铜铁利器的时候，你不只会打造锄头来锄地，你甚至会打造利剑来伤人。
The moment people how to invent the gunpowder,
当人发明火药的时候，
It's not only for the good, but also for weapon to destroy.
不是只有用在好的地方，甚至也是用在不好的地方。
But they can kill even more.
他们可以一次杀了更多人。
Because their sinful nature.
因为人身上带着罪性。
If you look at verse 23,
如果我们来看二十三节。
Verse 23,
二十三节。
One, two, three.
拉麦对他两个
妻
子
说：“
亚
大、
希拉，听
我
的声音。”
拉麦
的
妻子
细
听
我
的
言
语。壮年人
伤
了
我，
我
把
他杀
了。
少
年
人损
我，
我
把
他
害
了。Here tell us, when technology can advance, but the human heart, the sin, the evilness is always there.
科技可以更进步，可是人心中的罪性可以不断的扩大。
If you don't have technology, one person can only kill one person.
如果没有这些科技，一个人顶多可以杀另外一个人。
But with technology, one person can kill 1,000.
可是有这些科技的帮忙，一个人可以杀掉一千个人。
This explains today why human being society is so advanced.
这就是可以告诉我们今天的社会为什么这么发达。
But human heart, human become more and more evil.
可是人心却越来越邪恶。
Because personal altar to God was broken.
因为神人在对神的个人祭坛已经破裂了。
People are disconnect with God.
人已经与神失去连线
了。Now, what kind of age are we in right now?
所以我们现在到底是进入一个什么样的时代呢？
It's not a space age anymore.
不是一个太空时代。
Now we call it the AI age.
我们现在来到人工智能的时代。
AI will become dominant topic from now on until a very long time.
从现在开始最热门的话题就是人工智能。
Why everybody is so crazy about AI?
每个人都很想要多了解一些。
But also AI can also destroy human being.
可是其实人工智能到最后也是可以摧毁人类。
Not only taking up all our jobs.
不是只有把人类的工作都取代了。
In the future, AI assassin, AI killer, all the drones can kill people. They just enter your face, they can fly and kill you. Don't only to send a person.
未来这些无人机或是无人机器人，只要是输入你的人脸，他们就可以被派遣过来杀人。
Human are so smart making all this.
人是非常聪明，可以发明这一些。
But because our heart is not connected to God.
可是因为人们的心是没有与神连接。
So there will be more and more evil as technology advances.
所以当科技越来越发达，人心会越来越邪恶。
But what can we do?
那我们该如何做呢？
We cannot change the world.
我们没有办法改变这个世界。
But we can change ourselves.
可是我们可以改变自己。
There's another line of people.
有另外一条线。
Because one line is the Cain, the children of Cain, they don't believe in God, they are very smart, they make all this invention.
因为一条线是从该隐连接下来的，他的子孙很聪明，他们发明了很多东西。
Now another line,
另外一条线
is verse 25.
我们来看二十五节。
One, two, three.
亚当
又
与
妻
子
同
房，
他
就
生
了一
个
儿
子，起名叫
赛
特。
意
思说
神另给
我
立了一
个
儿
子代
替
亚
伯，
因
为该
隐
杀了他。
Now, there's another line of people totally different than the line of Cain.
这是另外一条线，与该隐那一条线完全不同。
Because Cain already left the presence of God.
因为该隐已经离开神的面。
They developed themselves.
他们是自己发展的。
So Adam and Eve, they have another child. God blessed them with another child.
这时候神祝福亚当夏娃，让他们有另外一个孩子。
And then they named him Seth.
他们给他取名叫赛特。
Because he said, wow, God has seen this and then it gave me another one.
因为他们说神另外给我立了一个儿子代替亚伯。
Now, this line is different.
这条线就完全不同了。
What is the major difference?
到底最主要是什么不同呢？
The Bible did not record Seth invented anything.
圣经并没有记载赛特发明了任何东西。
He was not a prominent musician.
他也不是一个很厉害出色的音乐家。
He was not an agricultural expert or know how to take care of cattle with a mass production.
他也不是很厉害知道如何放牧牲畜的人。
He was not a metalsmith. He didn't know how to make gold or silver.
他也不是一个可以打造铜铁利器的人。
He also was not a businessman. How to design a city?
他也不是一个生意人，知道如何去发展一个城市。
He was none of the so-called successful people in this world.
他在这个世人眼中的标准应该不算一个成功的人。
He is nobody. He just like anyone who just make a living and then get old.
他就是一个平凡人。
But there's one thing he did right.
可是有一件事他做对了。
What is it?
什么呢？
Verse 26.
二十六节。
Verse 26.
二十六节。
One, two, three.
And was the
Seth. To him also a son was born, and he named him Enos. Then man began to call on the name of the Lord. After Seth became a father,
当赛特成为一个父亲之后,
he made a very major change.
他做了一个非常主要的改变。
He decided we have to reconnect with God.
他决定要与神重新连线。
The Bible didn't say what happened to him.
圣经没有说他到底发生了什么事。
But only say that after he became a father, and that man began to call on the name of the Lord.
只有提到说，当他成为一个父亲之后，人就求告耶和华的名。
Maybe something has happened the Bible did not record.
可能有一些事情发生了，只是圣经没告诉我们。
Maybe he come to understanding.
可能他渐渐的了解。
Maybe he has observed his own father.
或者是他看到观察自己的父亲。
My father has departed from God.
我的父亲离开了神。
Look at what the family became right now.
我的家庭后来变成什么样子呢？
My oldest brother killed my second brother.
我的大哥杀了我的二哥。
My second brother is dead.
我的二哥就死了。
My oldest brother is gone.
我的大哥已经离开了。
Now, what am I going to do?
现在我该怎么做呢？
He made a decision.
他就做了一个决定。
He wanted to repair the relationship with God.
他想要修补与神的关系。
You know, he said, from then on, man started to call on the name of the Lord.
这里记载，那时候人才求告神的名。
And that is the turning point.
那就是一个转捩点。
Because without this, the faith will not pass on to the next generation.
因为如果他没有这样做，信仰就无法传承下去。
And we read on, there are many, many generations.
我们继续读下去就会发现接下来有很多的世代。
They are very simple people.
他们都是普通人。
They live certain age and they raise kids and then they get old, they die.
他们活到某个年纪然后生儿养女最后他们就死了。
But this is a generation of faith.
可是这是有信仰的这一线。
Because from then we know Enoch is in this line who walked with God.
因为到后来我们就会读到有一个人叫以诺他与神同行。
And then also later from Enoch's line also have Noah who is the righteous person.
在以诺下去那一条线呢我们就可以认识到挪亚他也是一个敬拜神的义人。
It is all because of Seth. After he became a father and then man started to call about the name of the Lord.
这些人的信仰都来自于他们的先祖就是赛特。
How do they call on the name of the Lord?
他们是如何求告神的名呢?
Of course, they have to build an altar.
因为他们一定要建造一个祭坛。
They have to reconnect with God.
他们要修补与神的关系。
Now, they may not be successful in the eyes of the world.
可能在世人眼中，他们看起来不怎么成功。
But they are the people of God.
可是他们属神，他们是属神的子民。
Now, brother and sister, among us, we are not many scientists or big politicians or very billionaires here.
弟兄姐妹，我们在座的没有很厉害的建筑师，或者是成功的商人，有亿万身家。
We just have a normal job, live a normal life.
我们只是有很平凡的工作，过着很平凡的生活。
Raise kids.
每天就带着自己的孩子。
And then we get old.
然后我们渐渐变老。
And one day we will die.
有一天我们也会死去。
But there's something more than that.
可是有什么事情是比那个更重要的?
If today you start to rebuild your relationship with God,
就是在今天如果你重建与神的关系,
your value is different than the people in this world.
你的价值观与世人不同。
Nowadays when you look at the social media, a lot of them are magnifying, glorying the rich, the beautiful, the successful.
今天如果你看这些社交媒体，你就会看到很多人在晒富，在炫富。
And then...make people to admire the celebrity or billionaires.
让这些平凡人去羡慕这一些亿万富豪或者是这一些明星的生活。
Make them their idols.
把他们当成偶像。
But those are not the true value of human life.
可是这些都不是真正的价值观。
The true human life, what is the value?
真正的人的价值在哪里？
When they will die.
有一天我们会死。
Where are we going after we die?
到底人死后会去哪里呢？
And Enoch tell us what will happen.
以诺就告诉我们会发生什么事。
Let's turn to chapter 5 verse 21.
我们来读第五章二十一节。
Chapter 5 verse 21 to 24.
第五章二十一到二十四节。
1-3. Enoch lived 65 years and begot
Methuselah
22.
以诺生
马
图
撒
拉
之
后，
与
神
同
行
三
百
年，
并
且
生
儿
养
女。
23. 23.
以诺共活了365岁。
24. 24.
以诺与神同行，神将他取去，他就不再
世
了。 So after the generation of rebuilding the altar,
当人们开始建造自己的祭坛，
reconnect with God,
与神连接上，
God gave human a hope,
神就给人希望，
through Enoch,
透过以诺，
because Enoch chose to walk with God,
因为以诺选择要与神同行，
God have chosen him, God have taken away him,
神将他取去，
taking him away, and then he's no more in the world.
他就不再是了。
This to tell us that there's something more than pursue physical success.
这里就看见什么是比追求个人的成功更重要的。
We are not belong to this world.
我们不属于这个世界。
We have a higher hope.
我们有更高的希望。
So thank God today, this spiritual convocation, we all come before the Lord.
所以感谢神，今天灵恩会，我们大家都来到神的面前。
Now we're going to spend more time in prayer.
现在我们要花更多时间来祷告。
We have to think about what is the situation of my personal altar, personal life.
我们要回想自己现在的情况是个人的祭坛情形如何。
Am I being carried away by the busyness of this world?
我是不是被这世界上的忙碌所带走呢？
Am I my focus pursuing, looking after, chasing the material abundance or physical success?
我的个人目标是不是总是在追求这个世界上的成功呢？
Or do we want to be like Enoch?
或者是我们想要像以诺一样？
I want to walk with God in my very short life.
想要在我这个短暂人生当中追求神呢？
And one day God will take me.
有一天神会将我取去。
So now this is a spiritual convocation. We ask brother and sister to come to the front to pray.
现在因为是灵恩会，我们请所有的弟兄姐妹到前面来祷告。
We ask God to help us to reconnect with Him.
我们求神帮助我们能够重新与他连接。
His Spirit touch us once again.
让他的灵重新碰触我们。
So that we can love Him more.
这样我们就可以更爱他。